This is a reply to my own video, and the funny part about this is this. One video I said I won't vote for Obama because of his name. In one video I said I will only vote Obama because of that little monkey t-shirt. The fact of the matter is this, nobody's gonna know how the fuck I'm gonna vote. So I'm gonna say what I feel at that moment. And at the moment I film this, I'm not gonna vote Obama. For various reasons other than his name. If you look at the way things have been drawn out and set up in front of you, you will see that he's not the person to vote for. If anything, allow them to put a target on the other guys or the other girl. Allow that target to be placed on somebody else. Because throughout the course of American history, when a black man stood up and white people listened, they shot him down. Nobody wants to sign somebody else's death certificate. So based on these videos and the events of today, I would not vote for Obama because he's worth more to me alive than dead. You don't understand that. I didn't think you would. Do you understand that? So I'm not voting for him. No, I'll vote for Hillary. You know, yeah, Hillary, 08. 8 more years of Clinton, baby. Hillary. Go Hillary. Is that what you want to hear? Is that it? I'm going to vote for Hillary because she's not Obama. And I hope she don't pick him as the vice president. That'll still give them the reason. You understand that? Maybe you don't. And then some other videos, I said I would vote for myself. So maybe I'm not going to vote for Hillary. I'm going to vote for me. I'm going to vote for the real AIX for president, 2008. Because I'd rather some idiot shoot at me. Someone who's lived a life not blessed, but blessed enough to give a message, than someone who's trying to give a message, who's trying to live the right life. You wouldn't understand that either. Am I talking to somebody out there? Is there anybody out there on the other side of this understanding what I'm saying? Maybe not. Maybe I'm just looking through that little bitty thing right there and I can't see nothing. Maybe it's broken. Or maybe you want me to speak like this. I'm gonna break it down. My vote is my vote. If I choose to run for president, it would be just like every day in this country. We have people dying and struggling. We need a leader that can take this country and turn it around. I don't want to just promise you jobs. I want to guarantee and give you jobs. There's an opportunity in this country to teach every American, and every American deserves the education that they've had, that they could have had, that they deserve to have. Every American needs a laptop in their house so they can learn. If you don't have a laptop, I'm willing to give you one. And as the President of the United States of America, I understand this grass crunch. We're paying far too much, and right here in my own state of California, just yesterday, I paid $4.20 for a gallon of the crappiest unleaded. 87, baby. Do you understand the significance of what's going down in our country? Our addiction to oil reaches far beyond just filling up our gas tanks. Think about it, America. If we opened up companies, green companies, we can rebuild our country from the inside out to give us the infrastructure we need to move forward into the future. I am willing to offer each and every American a new car if you give up your old car. Yes, an American car made in American factories by Americans. I'm willing to open up a factory in each state to build different components for this car to be put together in the greenest way possible. We will build electric cars to power our future. And yes, on the education front, which I briefly spoke on, I would build these same factories in every state to build computers to give to Americans. So you wouldn't have to try to afford to buy a computer to teach your kids the basic necessities of computing, the wave of the future. I will give these things to the American people if only the opportunity to give them to you. That's what I would do. These factories that have left the country, I would bring them back. How? See, other countries ask us for foreign aid. They ask us aid for this, aid for that. Instead of sending them the money that we need here, I will send them the product they ask for. As your president, how can I mobilize the people? Just like in World War I and II, I will make four jobs. I will bring four jobs. Bring them forth so everyone can work. When we were battling the Germans, we built tanks. Now we're battling oil. Why don't we build cars that run on something other than gas? We're at a war with education. We have dumb kids graduating from school to run amok in our streets. Why don't we put education in the household? If you can sit there and type up what you want to type up on YouTube and surf the internet, how come you can't sit there and type and get you an education? We have the resources and the technology to rebuild this country, but do we have the effort? Not from our politicians. Do we have the desire? Not from our politicians. Do we have the courage to move forward and cut loose that gas that we suck down our pipes every day just to get from A to B? Do we have the power to go cold turkey? No. But we do have the power to rebuild America from the inside out and not from the outside in. How can we continue to rebuild these other countries overseas and die at home? How can we continue to make sure the next nation can flourish and we let ours wither? I'm not speaking on just jobs for blacks and whites and Mexicans. I'm speaking for jobs and education for every American, old and young. We need to get off this damn pity pot that we sit on. The world hates us. The world hates us because of our actions, and actions speak louder than words. We can't tell you that we love you and we want to help you and then send a bomb over your head next week. As the President of the United States of America, you won't have to worry about us being in your business anymore. Because when you need something from us, you got to ask us. We won't assume that you need us, so don't come ask us for nothing. In my country, we do live free. In my country, we're all equal. And in my country, every American has the opportunity to live. You say we all have the opportunity to live. No, we all struggle. We all need. We all have addictions to everything. Cable, video games, TV, and the internet. We are an addicted nation. We're blindsided by what a handful of people want us to do. We need to step up, stand up, get up and get out of our homes and become real again. This how you want me to speak? Is that how you want me to act? To bring forth change, you have to first want it. I'm not going to vote for Obama because he wants change. I'm not going to vote for Obama because of this or because of that. I'm not going to tell you who I'm going to vote for. Based on that video, based on them talking about killing this man, throwing out blatant hints, I wouldn't vote for him just to save his life. And in saying that, is America that snaky? Yes, it is. Our country has misled every one of us. And I can't fix it. All I can do is bring forth the light. And once I turn on the light, you gotta see it for yourself. So thank you, America. You've been tuned.